Now, the first thing you want to do is go ahead and open up Adobe Premiere. And when you do that, go ahead and hit New Project. When you hit New Project up on the top, let's just go ahead and name it whoever your interview is with. So if it was Mr. Fletcher, go ahead and put Fletcher Interview up there. Just go ahead and type that up there in the upper left-hand corner. And then in the bottom right-hand corner, just go ahead and hit Create. And all these boxes are going to pop up. You're going to be concerned with the box right here. And what we're going to do is we're going to grab that audio file you have of your interview, the M4A maybe, or whatever other file, and we're going to drag it down into that box, and it's going to create an audio file for us. So we see the audio right there, that waveform is there. We can look and we have it. We want to come up to this box in the upper right and come down to captions and graphics next. You go ahead and click on that, and then it's going to come up to some boxes over here, and we see transcribe sequence. I'm going to select that. I'm going to go ahead and hit transcribe sequence right up here in the top. And then we want to make sure it's in English, and we'll go ahead and just probably use the defaults the vast majority of the time, and we'll hit transcribe. And then it's going to take a little bit of time for it to run through this. You're going to see that box working right there, and it works out really, really well. It's just a reminder, you're probably going to be recording these things on your phone, so you just need to airdrop your audio file from voice memos, or you go ahead and you can email that to yourself, download the file, and then that's the file that we get onto this computer somehow that we're going to bring in here to Premiere. Now, it is running through transcribing this whole thing. It does take a second. It's not lickety-split like a lot of the things that you use these days, but it is trying to process what people are saying and get all that right. And it's going to do a pretty good job. You're going to find that it's not 100% accurate, but you're going to be easily able to go and clean up stuff once it gets done. Now, you see here, it separates between speaker one and speaker two, and we've got all that great stuff there. Again, you might notice some things, but you'll see timestamps on there that are right there, so we could easily go find what to do. Now, if you click on those dots up there, we do need to export this as a text file. So the three dots up there, go down to export as a text file. I'm going to name it whoever we talk to, and then you need to save it in a place where you're going to find it. So if in documents or wherever it is, but we go ahead and export it. Now I go to documents and I go to where I downloaded it, and we see right there is the file as a .txt. So now what we need to do from there is we go into Google Drive, and to be able to get this where we can edit it, right, we're going to go to open. We're going to go over to upload, and you can do this different ways. We can drag and drop or upload, but it's going to do this where it comes in, and then it's going to show us this last step. Click in open in Google Docs, and it's going to open it up now in Google Docs as something we can easily edit and change and format, copy paste, and use in our story, and using Adobe Premiere and the transcribe works out super great. For you to save you a lot of time that you don't end up having to type things. Good luck with that. I hope you find it useful.